On number three, you're asked to do three things: create a table of values, a mapping diagram, and then graph the points that are in the relation. Now, nothing's too difficult about any of these things, but there are some specific rules that you have to follow just to make sure you get all the points you can out of this easy problem. So the table of values, you're just listing your x and y coordinates and in what we call an xy table. So your x coordinates, of course, go under x and y under y. The rule here is that you have to put your x coordinates in order. If an x or a y repeats, you put it in the table because you should have all five of your points in your table. So we're going to put the smallest x first, which we have a negative 2 as our smallest x, and it occurs twice, so I'm going to write it twice. And then the next smallest would be the negative 1s, which again happened twice, so I write it again both times. And then our largest x value is actually a 0. Now the y's won't necessarily be in order because they have to be next to the x that it goes with. So you don't mix up the points. You still want to have these same 5 points in your table. Since negative 2 occurs twice as an x, when you go to write your y values for negative 2, since there's 2 of them, put them from least to greatest order as well. So put the negative 4 first and then the positive 4. Same thing with your negative 1s, put the smaller y first and then the positive, the larger one, which is the positive 2, second. And then the y that goes with 0 is also a 0. So these are the same 5 points that are in your relation. They're just put in order based on the x coordinate, least to greatest order. In your mapping diagram, you're going to draw 2 what I call bubbles. And you're going to put your x coordinates in one bubble and your y coordinates in the other. Now on the mapping diagram, you put x and y in order. And on the mapping diagram, you do not show repeats. So when we put our x's in order, we already have them in order here, but we won't put the negative 2 twice or the negative 1 twice. We'll only write them once in the mapping diagram. The y values, the smallest y value out of our 5 is the negative 4. And then our next smallest is the negative 2, then the 0, then the positive 2, and then the positive 4. So all 5 of our y's were different, so they're just listed in order, least to greatest, in the mapping diagram. Your arrows are what show the 5 points. So you're going to draw an arrow from the negative 2 on the x to the y, or y's, plural in this case, that it goes with. So negative 2 should have an arrow to a positive 4, and negative 2 should have an arrow to the negative 4. Remember, that right there shows me it's not a function. The x is repeating, and that makes it not a function. Negative 1 goes to positive 2, and it also goes to negative 2. Again, making it not a function since the negative 1 is repeating. And the 0 goes to 0, so just one arrow from it. So you can count from your x's. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 arrows because you have 5 points. In the graph, this is really easy to graph points. You've been doing it for a while. Just make sure you double check that you don't miss easy points like this. Remember, the x coordinate tells you how far to go left or right from the origin, and the y tells you your up and down movement from the origin. So the point negative 2, 4, this negative makes you go left 2, and since it's a positive 4, that means up 4. So left 2, up 4, and I place my point. Negative 1, 2 would be left 1, up 2, left 1, up 2, the origin, 0, 0. Negative 1, negative 2 means left 1, down 2. And negative 2, negative 4 means left 2, down 4. You don't connect these points when you're just given 5 specific points to plot. That makes it a discrete relation, and you just plot the points and you're done.